So people with dementia have trouble and problem with short-term memory, the keeping track of a purse or a wallet, paying bills, planning, preparing meals, remembering appointments, traveling out of neighborhood. So I want to talk a little bit about each of these. Short-term memory. So you're going out, Jack, are you going out? Yes. Can you like put this out on your way out? Sure. And then you come back and Jack is gone, the thing is still there. So that's, he doesn't remember what you told him. Keeping track of purse or wallet. Every time, like twice a day, four times a day, you know, you keep asking, oh, where did I put my purse? Have you seen my wallet? Oh, what did I do with my newspaper? Where's my hat? Where's my umbrella? Remember, it's once in a while, it's okay. But if it's persistent, every day is happening about everything, that's abnormal. Paying bills. You know, if you have like four bills to pay every month and you're still missing five of those four bills, that's abnormal, okay? Planning, preparing meals. You know, like, oh, grandma had the best ravioli recipe, and then you go in and it's not like it used to be, and she didn't put the meat inside, and the mushroom was not there. And you're thinking like, maybe I should have gone out with my friends. So you're gonna see those, you know, changes that suddenly, you know, over a short period of time, they can't do what they used to do. And cooking is really a very complex task. It's like different steps. In your mind, you have to think, I'm gonna buy this from the store, then I'm gonna cook this, the onion, I have to do this. So it's a lot of actually complex tasks, multi-steps. And you'll see one of the things that actually we hear a lot from the patients or patient's family is that they can't cook anymore. They forget how to do it. There was a movie recently, I don't know if you guys saw that movie, and one of the things that when the character who had dementia forgot how to cook her recipe for Thanksgiving. So that's very common. Remembering appointments. Okay, you know, I had an appointment and I forgot. It happens to me every couple of years. But if we see a patient or a clinic that is missing, every time you make an appointment, then she's missing our GI appointment, then missing the cardiology appointment, or showing up on another day. When we're sitting there, like then Mrs. Smith comes in, oh, I'm here for my appointment. Hey, you know, your appointment was like 2 days ago. Oh, I thought it was. So those things are really red flags. Traveling out of neighborhood. So you see, somebody who's been living in this neighborhood for the last 30 years knows all the neighbors, knows the names of the dogs of the neighbors, the grandchildren of. They know everything. And then suddenly they go out and they don't come back. They get lost. They end up somewhere else. So those are red flags. And that's very dangerous, you know, like. It can have a lot of problems. And then, unable to remember things. One of the first things that happens with dementia is like short-term memory. And then asking the same question, repeating the same story over and over. Because they don't remember, they already told you that. So say, oh, you know, you remember, you know, I did this and that. Oh, okay, that was really funny. And then like 5 minutes later, oh, did I tell you that story about this and that? Oh, you told me. When? Oh, let me tell you again. And then he tells you again. Then 5 minutes later, say, so this is something that's really not typical of a normal aging. This is something that's like a red flag, something that we should really consider, really what's going on. We're asking the same question. Oh, where's the pill cutter? Where's the remote? Oh, it's there. Okay. Honey, where's the remote? Oh, it's there. Okay, great. And you go back. Oh, honey, where did you put the remote? So that's a red flag. That's something that's kind of unusual.